Good fellow. Quite the cozy setup you have here. I'll just make myself comfortable. Thank you so much. I was just settling in and reviewing my latest findings. Mind flayers, cultists, and, of course, your esteemed company. Why, I'm practically an expert. They've tentacles, you know. Quite shocking. The druid Halson had some kind of mind flare specimen in a jar in his quarters. A replica, no doubt, but truly fascinating to see up close.
As a matter of fact, I do.
But why do you?
That's quite impossible. You'd have undergone ceramorphosis by now.
I can't attest to the specifics, but I do know that not long after insertion, the host, that's you, turns into a mind flayer. As there's not a tentacle on your head, I can only assume you haven't been infected. If what you say were true, you'd be a mind flayer by now.
You? Infected by a mind flayer? Ridiculous. Isn't it?
Perhaps that's for the best.
I'd be irresponsible not to debunk such a strange claim.
If I just peer in your eye, I could quickly...
Oh, my dear sweet gods!
I mean, yes.
I suppose I can.
I'll need to research the particulars, however. Give me a bit of time, and I'll have this little issue sorted.
Not over, then through.
Speak. Entirely. I was as devoted to my studies as I was to my training. Each creche contains a Zathisk purification device. So I learned from the writings in the Kalir Library. The library was a gift from Vlakith herself, that we may gain total understanding. Countless scholars roam the astral sea and beyond, observing the ways of our lessers, exploring planes so distant order turns to chaos and cold fires rage. The planes are ever quaking and their peoples ever shifting. The Githyanki possess an eternity of knowledge. Yet we still collect more, infinities upon infinities. It is done.
I suppose you want to hear about Cazador. Oh, then what do you want? Darling, I thought you'd never ask. Lead on.
Lady of Sorrows, guide us. Did you want something? All right. Some company wouldn't hurt on the road, especially if there's trouble. Shah's blessings upon you. I know. I felt it. Might not be possible. It's stubborn that way. Prone to lashing out. Keep it for now. But make no mistake. When the time comes, when we're cured, the artifact leaves with me.
Violence hasn't gone unnoticed. It's about to be returned in kind.
Let's go.
I can't even catch my breath. No time for mercy.
That won't work. An illithid parasite in that corpse. You should take a look.
This one is a true soul parasite. It can enhance you. You can absorb its potential. Open your mind to it. You already know how. You are not ready. That's all right. But try to overcome this resistance sooner rather than later.
You know, if that parasite isn't to your taste, I'd be happy to consume it in your stead. I don't relish the thought, but if you're going to just leave it sitting in your pack, well, one of us should try it. Excellent. I'll have a rummage around and help myself in my own good time. Thank you. You know, if that, I don't relish the thought, but if you're going to just leave it sitting in your pack, well, what? Oh, I have my reserve. Second, there's a non-zero chance that it'll turn me into a purple glist. But if it doesn't, who knows what kind of power we could unlock. And power is always worth a little risk. Ah, so that's how it is. Because if you continue to get between me and what I want, I will have to find a way through. Just something to think about.
Moving ahead.
What a day. Just like old times. Time for discretion.
You've wandered into a forbidden area. You sense it might be time to leave. You have outstayed your already flimsy welcome, and now you will leave.
Onward.
Keep your distance, darling.
Let's get on with it.
Blackets will be done. You've set foot in a restricted area. A swift exit may be in order. Managed to talk your way in. No easy feat. Tempers are rising.
Quick step. On tippy toes. The element of surprise.
Theft has been reported, and it seems you're the only suspect. Choose your next step. You hand over the spoils of your pilfering.
Let's be quick. That might be worth a look.
That thing is small.
And I am not.
No one back home will ever believe this. How much farther can I go?
What is this?
What's that?
Here we go.
You again.
No traps, please.
Tempers are rising.
Should speak up.
You again. You're staring at me again.
Something's blocking it from the other side.
Shukok, Otashokek Dors! I command you, corpse, speak, reveal truth to the Absolute!
By Vlakith's blade, a geich.
Nothing. Must be reading it wrong. Shuganashukok!
The hobgoblin turns to you. And the parasite squirms in your skull. You taste the ale on his tongue and the bile in his soul. The visions cloud your inner eye for a brief moment once again. You see the hobgoblin bowing before the armored elf you'd glimpsed before. The elf speaks of the hunt for a great weapon and the rewards that will go to whoever finds it. The hobgoblin's eyes gleam hungrily.
If it isn't another true soul.
He doesn't speak his next words, yet they still rattle your skull from within.
You ever talk to a dead squid? Now's your chance.
This Mind Flayer's build is smaller, its garb plainer. A fearsome creature even in death, but not the one that tormented you. Yet it too roamed the Nautiloid. It would have seen you, known you.
Absolute says the dead Squiddy had a weapon. I reckon the killer nabbed it and scooted off to that looter camp. We find who killed it, and we find who took that weapon. So settle in.
You suddenly feel a strange anxiety take hold. Not your own, but that of the artifact you carry. Somehow, it's afraid. The artifact does not want to part from you. It does not want to fall into the Absolute's clutches. You choke on black smoke as the hobgoblin bellows that your heart seizes. Under questioning, the creature might recognize you as its killer. Raxlin's mind reels, then calms. He will speak as you command. With Raxlin's voice, you ask.
What did the killer want?
Raxlin scowls, shocked by his own words, and a jolt shoots through your skull. The creature speaks in visions. A swarm of Githyanki dragon riders, silver blades held high, control panels melting, flesh pods spilled open.
Githamant, they know something.
He is suspicious, confused by the question that fell from his lips. You proceed carefully.
Tell me who killed you, freak! No games!
Again, a vision comes to you. A memory, seen through the creature's soul-dead eyes. You see a clawed hand opening a holding pod. The murk clears to reveal a face. Yours.
That can't be. You. You're no true soul.
He is suspicious, confused by the question that fell from his lips. You proceed carefully.
Why were the Gith chasing that ship?
You see dark tunnels lit by noxious pools of brine. The darkness spreads through the earth. The sky splits open and Nautiloids pour out of a void that consumes the stars.
What in the...
Suspicion floods Raxlin's mind. Your brain howls as you force a final query into his throat.
true soul.
Collapses, silent once more.
No, no! I'm not done! Riddles, all of it, and nothing to show for the trouble but rotting squid meat! No answers, no killer, and no damned weapon! The damned Trow was right. Can't let her get all the glory. Seems I ain't done with you. Report to the Drow. Minthar is the name. She's mounting an attack on that blasted grove. Tell her you'll join her. Praise the Absolute.
These cultists seek a weapon. Could they mean the artifact that we carry?
A scrying eye. Best not do anything suspicious while it's watching.
The prisoner can keep his tongue, his spikes, Albie.
Bloody hells, what? Leave me alone!
What are they delaying for? Can't we just swarm the forest?
Drow wants to know exactly where those adventurers came
and
from.
A few
what are they doing? Hiding in trees?
These friars, they're prepared to fight for the Absolute.
What they do ain't exactly fighting. All they gotta do is light up a power.
Then they're prepared to die for the Absolute.
Good. Dying's the only thing they're good at.
I tell you, the scrying eye was looking at me all strange.
Right. What would some drow wizard in Moonrise want to look at you for?
Certainly you won't be because of your beautiful eyes.
What are they...
Poor lad. I could give you peace, you know. But no. You gotta keep silent, don't you? Where do they flee to, you stubborn rat?
Please, stop!
Ah, here to see your friend, have ya? Come and join him if you like.
The mark glows. But you feel nothing in response. Your illithid power is beyond reach until you rest.
The git snuck in here with his mate, looking for some forgotten thing. Said they ran to some kind of grove. He doesn't want to tell us where it is, but he can't resist forever. No! Why won't he speak? The drow's gonna kill me if I can't make him talk. We do all the work, and you get to finish him? Bah! Take him! Won't do you any good. He just screams. Should have sent him to Moonrise with the rest for all the good he's been. I want to watch that weird priest next door. Sounded like he was beating something up. Oh, yeah, beating it good.
What? The prisoner?
Speak.
Please, please. Let me out. There's no reason for this. Helsin, I don't know. He changed into a bear, but I lost sight of him. I don't know if he's still alive.
That's all I know.
Please, get me out of here. Thank you. Thank you so much. Please, hurry.
More for me? What's up for discussion? I'll give it a shot.
Do you think the dwarf is...
Keep your hands steady, Three.
Again! Again!
Make it squeal again. We're juicing it up. The beast came in here with those robbers, killed Dink and Mince too. Boss is thinking of serving it to the wargs. We made it squeal.
Look, look, you'll see. Give me that rock. I'll show ya.
again.
Breathe deep and move.
We're juicing it up. The beast bosses the... We might...
Look, look, you'll see! Give me that rock! I'll show ya!
What are ya?
Get lost if you can't stand a bit of roughhousing. We're juicing it up, bosses. The
we made.
Look, look, you'll see. Give me the.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, please.
What's next?
Can't slow down.
You think the dwarf is ready?
Keep your...
Again!
Make it squeal again. Again.
Try me.
Thank you.
have to keep going.
Try something else.
One day, I'll catch a break.
Got to focus. No mercy.
Let me
I will ascend.
mystery awaits.
Pardon the viscera. One should cherish all of nature's bounty, but goblin guts are quite far down the list. You aided a bear without knowing if it would savage you. A true friend of nature. Or perhaps a lunatic. Either way, I owe thanks. I am the druid Halsin. Indeed. Well, not the most opportune moment, but given the lengths you went to, I assume there's some urgency. Come on then, what's the problem? Unless you'd rather wait for an audience of goblins. Oak Father preserve you, child. You're infected, aren't you? The Mind Flayer's spawn. But something's different. You're aware of the monster inside you. You don't bow to the Absolute like the true souls do. How is this possible? Perhaps. But I wouldn't want to place all my faith in blind luck. You weren't speaking lightly when you said you needed help. Let me tell you what I know. I've been studying these parasites for a while now. Ever since I discovered these so-called true souls are infected with them, someone is using very powerful magic to modify these tadpoles. They're using them to exert control over the infected. I'm sorry to say, I can't undo that magic, which means I can't cure you. But that doesn't mean I can't help. I didn't find what I came here for, a way to remove the tadpoles. But I found the next best thing. I found out where they come from. That must be where these enchantments are placed on them. And it's where you'll find your cure. I overheard that the cultists are sending all of their captives to Moonrise Towers. Innocents go in, true souls come out. Given that all of these true souls are infected, it has to be the source for this magic. If you want to find a cure, you must head there and discover how the tadpoles are being manipulated. Wait, I could help you find a cure, but I need to settle matters here first. I've no right to ask more of you, but if you could help me, I'd be free to join your journey to Moonrise. I cannot allow these butchers to threaten my grove. The natural order must be protected. My thanks. If you prevail, I'll owe you the debt of a lifetime. Rare is the beast that survives decapitation. Help me eliminate the Drow Minthara, the Hobgoblin Draw Ragslin, and that perversion of a priestess Gut. They are the ones holding these parasites together. Remove them, and nature will cure itself. Be warned. My presence could make things more difficult. I can only restrain my bear form so much. I won't be able to help but attack goblins. If I join you, we'll likely have to slaughter this entire place. You may want to use discretion when approaching the goblin leaders. May Sylvanas guide your hand. Focus on the leaders. That's all it will take to restore the balance here.
This way.
Decaying legs protrude from the hole. A failed escape, it seems. decaying legs protrude from the hole. A failed escape, it seems. It seems the tunnel collapsed mid-dig and suffocated him. A crooked heart is embroidered on his left shoe. Loose, revealing a tunnel. Perhaps you can escape where he failed.
Tunnel's still blocked. It'll take a bit more effort to clear it.
All's well that ends not as bad as it could have.
Still blocked. This should be easy enough to clear. Still blocked. This should be easy enough to clear. No use digging here.
This way.
Shouldn't have wished to live in more interesting times. Light on my feet. Let's see what this does. Still blocked. This should be easy enough to clear.
Just saying, those eyes.
Again, do you want it?
Someone there. Let's move.
You fertilize the fields with the dead.
Stop me yet. Swift as my feet can carry me.
Rivers and streams will flow with their blood. Their cities will be razed to the ground.
Oh, sit.
Well, hello. Tread lightly.
Sort of fight, and now you have one.
time to press ahead.
Has not returned, and half of the intruders escaped your guards.
Sorry, mistress. We mucked up.
Until their sanctuary is found, I will take something precious from you every hour that passes. A trinket, a tongue, a limb.
Ain't no use without my limbs. The lad'll make the prisoner squeal soon enough, I swear.
Silence now, creature. Or I will silence you forever.
As she turns to you, her thoughts mingle with yours. A cold hand caressing your brain. The chamber melts away to reveal a dark, endless nowhere. In it, you see a vision. The drow listens as a pale-eyed young woman whispers in her ear. One of those the voice spoke of. One of the chosen. The vision fades away.
A true soul? Praise be. Are you here to join my hunt? Yes. I suppose I might offer passage. But first, we hunt. Prove yourself worthy, and you will have what you seek. Worshippers of a false god. Their existence is an insult to the Absolute's claim on this region. There is a weapon the Absolute seeks. I'm sure those wretches have it hidden away there. We will find it amongst the dead and the ashes.
Her excitement is palpable. She lingers on thoughts of victory, of unbelievers' blood spilled, and of the weapon. She will seize it in the Absolute's name.
The thief, whimpering in our dungeon, tried to flee to their sanctuary. We will continue to remove parts of him until he tells us exactly where it is.
He's been resilient, but he'll talk.
She is seeking the grove you visited. Already you feel her mind closing around yours.
Speak, true soul. The hunt must begin soon.
Excellent. Be sure not to kill him before he talks.
doing. It's just the same thing, over and over.
I need a quick word.
Please, get me out.
The lock clicks and opens.
Thank you. I better go before they catch us. I should be able to make it to the Grove on my own. They need to know they're in danger.
The Grove. To the east. They wanted to know where we came from.
Wish I had a bag of holding.
Just swarm the forest.
Drow wants to know exactly where those adventurers came from.
What are they doing? Hiding in trees? We'll smoke them out, no.
They hold me in once. And now you dare to question me.
Report. Didn't mean nothing by
and make it quick. Organizing these creatures tests my patience. So close. Their fate is sealed, and you will be instrumental in the slaughter. Go to their refuge, and make your way inside. As a friend. I will gather a raiding party and move into position. You will open the gates from the inside when the time is right to strike. We will cleanse the place of infidels and burn it to the ground in the Absolute's name. And then we will be the first among her favorites. Good. Marshalling the goblins is no simple matter, but my warband will be ready to attack by next light. You must make your way inside. Once I am in position, on your signal, we break them. And when they are dead, the Absolute will reward your faith. As will I. For the Absolute.
Gather the raiders. It is
yes,
time.
Yes, your ladyship. We won't let you down.
We have found our prey.
join me. The Absolute demands blood. We're invincible!
Nothing could stop us.
Seems simple enough.
If you fail me, the spiders will be there.
A disgusting waste of stonecraft.
The ringleaders have to die. The very natural order of things is in danger, thanks to them. Traveling to Moonrise is no small task. Expect dangers like you've never seen before. To get to the towers, you'll need to pass through a terrible place. This curse shrouds everything. Any who linger are twisted by the curse. They become shadow beings, tormented, dangerous souls.
If you can find this place, I'll wager it will reveal a more direct path to Moonrise Towers.
The decision is yours, but I'd fa- One of the adventurers had a clue to help find it, a dwarf called Brian. It might still be found on his corpse, wherever the goblins left it. Anything is preferable to risking the Shadow Curse.
It seems the absolute farewell.
Report, and make it quick. Organizing these creatures tests my patience. Go to their refuge, and make your way inside. We will be the first among her favorites.
you. And when they forth,
gather the raiders. It is
yes,
time.
Yes, your ladyship.
May the darkness protect you. Let's try this way.
No prisoners.
Tush!
We strike down on the
bloody racket. Oh, come on now. They're just having a bit of
a disgusting waste of stonecraft.
Goblins are such vile parasites.
Given your own nature, are you really?